In this video, we are going to look at the ConnectFX Clip available in Autodesk Smoke. So what is the ConnectFX Clip? Well, it's not a source clip that you can import, and it's not a sequence you can conform. A ConnectFX Clip can only be created in the ConnectFX node-based compositing environment, hence the name. So what is its purpose, and how can you use it? There are two practical uses for the ConnectFX Clip: disk caching and flexible versioning. Let's start off with caching. For this scenario, let's say that you're creating a large and complex composite in the ConnectFX schematic. Understandably, with levels of complexity and processing, performance is compromised and render times grow longer. This is where the ConnectFX Clip can definitely help. To create a ConnectFX clip, right-click on the node from where you would like the ConnectFX clip to be created. Choose Create CFX. Smoke will create a new clip in the ConnectFX schematic. The new CFX clip is the combination of all the effects from the nodes you have selected and all of its downstream inputs. You could think of this as nesting, grouping, or even containing the effects. To identify a CFX clip, just look for the CFX title under the clip's thumbnail. Now you can connect the CFX clip back into the ConnectFX tree and delete the old nodes because you don't need them anymore. Now this CFX clip is unrendered. You can leave it this way if you want, but to use it as a caching tool, switch to the timing menu. The timing menu represents the CFX clip like it does with regular source clips. The dotted line indicates that the CFX clip is not rendered. Select the clip and press the render button. Smoke will create new frames for the CFX clip. So now that all the frames are rendered to disk, Smoke will be faster because it does not have to process a chain of effects to get the result shown in the CFX node. It simply calls the frames from disk. This is not a RAM caching function that you might be used to in other desktop software. If you want to make a change to any other point in the ConnectFX tree, you do not have to re-render or recache the CFX clip. When you render the entire ConnectFX composite, Smoke will use the cache frames from the CFX clip, and the overall render will be much faster. However, if you need to change something that was created within the CFX clip, you can right-click on the clip and expand CFX. The CFX clip is completely non-destructive, so it will restore all the nodes as they were, and you can make updates to the branch. These updates will delete the original rendered frames because now they don't match your changes. But if you want to cache the section again, simply create the CFX clip and render it. This next scenario is simply about flexibility. Starting back in a ConnectFX example, you are tasked with creating a graphical effect that must be used in a series of shots. To add to this, you would also like to use it as a preset on another shot, as well as sharing it between projects, and finally backing it up for archival purposes. This branch represents the background, and this branch comprises of nodes that make up the graphical element that are composited on top of the background. I also want to quickly point out that the graphical elements start at the first frame of the composite. This might seem random mentioning that now, but it will make sense in a minute. Let's create a CFX clip from this node branch. Once again, you can connect it into the main branch and delete the old nodes if necessary. Now you can switch to the timing view. Let's say we want the graphical elements to start later in the composite. This is not a problem with the CFX clip because you can use the timing view to offset the starting time. As I showed you earlier, there are animation keyframes in the CFX clip. Well, the good news is that the timing offset slides all the media and animation keyframes because it sees one CFX clip. As an extra function, you could also trim the CFX clip to shorten its timing in the composite. And if you were to expand the CFX clip now, all the keyframe and media is perfectly restored, but everything remembers the offset. This can help prevent loads of timing issues when animation and keyframes are spread across loads of node effects. I'll undo the expand operation and get back to the CFX clip. So you have seen how the CFX clip benefits you directly inside the current ConnectFX. What Smoke also does is create a CFX clip in the CFX sources section located in the media panel. So this panel shows you all the clips you are using in the currently opened ConnectFX composite. This also includes the CFX clip. So if you wanted to store the CFX clip as a preset or new version, simply click and drag the CFX clip into any folder in the media library. A new CFX clip is created in the media library that is separate from the current ConnectFX composite. Now you can use it wherever you want. So let's exit the ConnectFX for this composite. Now I want to apply the CFX clip to another segment, and this could be in another sequence or another project if you were sharing media libraries. All you have to do is go into the new segment with ConnectFX. You still have access to the media library in ConnectFX, and you can drag the CFX clip into the ConnectFX schematic. I'll quickly composite the graphic element over the background with a blend and comp node from the node bin. Finally, if you want to access the settings or update your version, just right-click on the CFX node and expand it to reveal all the nodes that were there before. The beauty about the CFX clip is you can always go between CFX clips and node branches, and you never get stuck with just one method or the other. You also have a great way to move your node effects between composites, sequences, projects, and finally archiving. Add disk caching to the list, and you have one small tool that can make a big difference to your workflow. So give the CFX clip a go, and thanks for watching.